said that you have to go to God through him. There's not a single hadith. So therefore, realize, sister, that if you have to ask Allah directly, we have to obey Allah and obey his messenger also. We have to love him, we have to respect him, but we can't worship him. Hope that answers the question.
I have a question from another non-Muslim brother. He is Yogendra Singh Maini. He seems to be a Sikh, and he asked that, can you please tell me the similarities between Sikhism and Islam?
Our Sikh brother has asked a very important question, that what are the similarities between Sikhism and Islam? And there are a lot. Time will not permit me to expound on all. I'll just mention in brief a few things. That Sikhism, it's a religion of 10 gurus, for those who don't know. And it was founded by Guru Nanak Sahib in the late 15th century in the land of Punjab, in the land of five rivers. And Guru Nanak, he was very much influenced even by the Muslims. He was born in a Kshatriya family, in a warrior class Hindu family. He was influenced by the Muslims, many Muslims. And the five Ks that the Sikh always maintain is the Kesh, that is the uncut hair. It is the Kanga, it is the comb to keep the hair clean. It is the Kala, that is the bracelet. The fourth is the Kacha, the long underdraws. And the fifth, it is the Kirpan, it is the dagger. This is identity, in short. This was a brief about a Sikh. So moment, mashallah, you see a person wearing a turban, he's identified. Therefore, I always appreciate that the person who keep the label without any fear are the Sikhs. Therefore, if you hear my talk on if the label shows their intent, I tell the Muslims that mashallah, the Sikh, he's proud to be a Sikh. And he even fought with the Canadian government in the army. They said, you shave off that. He said, no, I will not. And he fought the case and they won. When I went to Canada the first time in 1996, it came as headline that a Sikh fights the case in the Canadian army and he wins the case. But we Muslims, many of us, someone did something, we shave off the beard. Why? Now coming to the similarities between the Sikhism and Islam, the sacred book of the Sikh is the Guru Granth, or known as Adi Granth. And if you read the first chapter of this Adi Granth, first chapter, first volume, first chapter, first verse, it's called as Japuji. And it says that Almighty God, he is called as the true. He is the true. Not created. The fearless. He is not begotten. And he is free from fear and want. If you analyze, he is one, he is not begotten, he is the creator. It is similar to our Surah Ikhlas, chapter number 112, verse number 1 to 4, which says, Qul huwa Allahu ahad. Says Allah one and only. Allahu samad. Allah the absolute and eternal. Lam yalid wa lam yulad. He begets not, nor is he begotten. Wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. Nothing like him. And in Sikhism, Sikhism does not believe in avatarvada, meaning that God has got avatar. It's a monotheistic religion. God, in the unmanifest form, is called as Omkara, and manifest form as Ek Omkara. And there are various attributes of Almighty God given in the Guru Granth. Amongst them is, he's called as Kartar. That is the creator. Same in Arabic as Khalik. He is called as Parvardigar, the cherisher. Same as us, Rab. He is called as Lord, as Rab. He is also called as Kareem, the benevolent. He is called as Rahim, beneficent. He is also called as Waheguru, one God. So if we analyze, there are many similarities between the concept of God in Sikhism. Therefore, Sikhism doesn't believe in idol worship. Doesn't believe in avatarvada. It's a monotheistic religion. And if we analyze, Guru Nanak was very much influenced even by Sant Kabir. And you find in the Granth many couplets also of Sant Kabir. One of them is Dukh mein sumran sab kare, sukh mein sarak, sukh mein kare na koi. Dukh mein sumran sab kare, sukh mein kare na koi. Jo sukh mein sumran kare to dukh kaay hoye. Which means, in time of trouble, everyone remembers God. In time of happiness, no one remembers God. If you remember God in time of happiness, why should trouble touch you? Same as Allah says in Surah An'am, chapter number 6, verse 103, that when trouble toucheth man, he cries out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But once when the trouble goes away, he associates partners with others. So if you realize that Sikhism is also a religion of one God, it's a monotheistic religion, does not mean idol worship. Those scholars say it's an amalgamation of Hinduism and Islam. And we realize that in the concept of God, it is quite similar to Islam. And for more details, you can refer to my video because the concept of God in major world religion, where I've spoken in more details on that. Hope that answers the question.
Inshallah, we'll just have the last two questions. Due to time, there's lack of time and we cannot continue. Maybe I have the next question from the brother over here.
They ask a question that he wants to know about Islamic banking. Islamic banking offer loan and they add a X percent, they call it service charge, whatever. Is it not interest? See, basically interest is haram in Islam. There are no less than 8 different places where Allah says interest is haram. Allah clearly says in Surah Baqarah chapter number 2, verse number 278 to 79, that if you give up not your demands for interest, take notice of a war from Allah and His Rasul. So interest is haram. Now, as far as Islamic banking is concerned, there are, as you mentioned, many Islamic banks which give loan. Point to be noted that most of the Islamic banks that are there, I don't know of any Islamic bank which is 100% Islamic. I don't know. Maybe. I don't know. In fact, one of my projects is this, one of my interests is Islamic banking. But there are many which are, mashallah, quite a lot Islamic. There are many which are frauds also. Fine. Only namesake Islamic. What we have to note that we as laymen, if we can check up. But if you analyze, there is Islamic system of musharika, profit and loss sharing, which is the best, safest. Musharika means you become a partner in it. Now, other aspects of the mudaraba is there. That is cost plus. In cost plus, many a times people falter. And many a times it's nothing but catching the nose with long cut, you know. Aisa nose pakadnega. Means, you know, you say that it is nothing but trying to make a gimmick. So we have to analyze. And many fatwas are given on this is allowed, that is allowed, which I don't agree with it also. So when an Islamic bank comes, we have to scrutinize who is on the Sharia board. Just by name, please don't go. That's not important. What they do, etc. So many of the Islamic bank, I wouldn't call them Islamic. They may be very small percentage Islamic. Now in the Islamic bank, most of them do mudaraba. In mudaraba, there's a problem, cost plus, which comes. Sometimes it's possible, ijara is there, that is higher purchase is there, which is Islamic, musharika, is safe. Safe means if they are following Islamic principles. No? In other parts, we have to check up. And what we analyze that most of the bank, they falter. And because they compete with the normal conventional bank, they keep the same interest, so name is different. Naam ka farak hai, label is different, but the same. But, so we have to be careful while taking loan. But as a layman, if suppose you think it is Islamic and you take it, and if they are doing something wrong, out of ignorance you have gone, so the blame will come on them, not on you. If you know they are haram and then you go, then the blame will come on you. So it is the onus of the people running Islamic banks to check up whether they are following. What happened? There are many fatwas in this Islamic. And fatwa shopping is very easy. You know what fatwa you want, you'll get. So they go and when Egypt will get, or Pakistan or India. So they take fatwa which is convenient for them, and then they sanction it. So you have to be careful while Islamic banking is there. Not that it's not possible. Possible, very difficult. There are some banks I know which are, mashallah, good, yet not 100%, and they know it's 100%, because unless you don't have the central system of Islamic, you can't be 100%. So the thing that there are many Islamic banks coming up, we have to check up whether Islamic or if it's there, but there is a system which you can do. So you have to check up the functioning, how they do, and then you have to decide whether right or wrong. Hope that answers the question.
Inshallah, we'll just have the last question from the sister.